Hi, I'm Greg Tito, and this is our video review of A Game of Thrones Genesis. On the heels of the HBO series and the release of A Dance with Dragons this summer, the time is ripe for a video game based on George R.R. Martin's fantasy epic. Real-time strategy seems like the perfect genre for Martin's brutal story of great houses vying for control of the Iron Throne of Westeros, but only if it somehow includes the court intrigue, backstabbing, and bastards that define the series.
I'm so sorry.
The mechanics for that kind of play work surprisingly well in Genesis, but unfortunately, the campaign fails to deliver the Storm of Swords I expected. See what I did there? Storm of Swords? Huh? The Seven Kingdoms of Westeros have a rich history, from the conquest of Aegon's dragons to Robert's Rebellion, and Genesis' biggest selling point was letting you relive those moments. Split into 8 chapters with 1-5 missions each, you will be able to invade Dorne or break the Blackfyre Resistance, for example. The problem is the missions themselves are less exciting to play than watching Littlefinger pick his nose. The designers have a bad habit of ending missions with epilogue text that describes events that are more interesting than the mission I just played. As Aegon the Conqueror, I subdued the Starks by killing merchants as they traveled from the outlying towns to Winterfell. Then I moved my dragon to a glowing blue circle. Whee! I won! I would have really liked for each location to be accurately labeled instead of just being called Feudal Home or Castle. Making an alliance with Greywater Watch or Torrhen Square instead of just Town would have meant a lot more to me. As a great lord, you hire mercenaries and raise armies using a curiously outdated interface, but the most useful agents are the non-combatants, which form a complex game with rock-paper-scissors elements. For instance, assassins can kill any single unit, but they operate in stealth for a short time, which only a stationary spy can detect. Moving a rogue into a town starts a rebellion, which can only be put down by guardsmen, while guards can only be killed by stronger military units like mercenaries and armies. Units have a tendency to bunch up on the map, forcing you to wrestle with selecting the right unit, which can be a drag when you're trying to react quickly. Despite the frustrating controls, I was really swept up in spreading my various agents across Westeros. Weaving a web of spies and rogues really makes you feel like Vetterus the Spider, reading messages from his little birds. But, you know, with your junk intact. Hopefully. Moving on. Choosing the best way to handle a situation is what makes Genesis' skirmish mode so much more fun than the campaign missions. In House vs. House, you pick a map like the Neck or the Reach and play an ahistorical Game of Thrones. I like that the goal in these games is not to take over the most territory or even kill the most units, although that certainly helps, but to be the first house to win 100 prestige points. These are earned by completing random challenges like seducing 2 units with a noble lady, for instance, and holding the lead in areas such as total wealth. Each hostile action pushes houses closer to war, but once war is declared,
hear ye, hear ye! Peace is over! War has been declared!
The rules change and diplomacy is no longer possible. Sending peace envoys can stall the war, as will releasing any arrested spies or assassins. So it's often better to avoid armed conflict if you don't have a big army. When you play the Game of Thrones game, you win or you die. Graphics-wise, I like the details in the landscape. These leaves on the ground are a nice touch. But the character animations are adequate at best. While the house versus house component is engaging and fits the setting, the inelegant interface and poor campaign design makes A Game of Thrones Genesis just disappointing. Given the source material, I was worried that the RTS gameplay would veer too far into clashing armies, but after playing through the 5 or 6 hour campaign, I actually wish there were a lot more epic moments like that. I mean, the Battle of the Bells is an exciting moment in the Seven Kingdoms. Why am I playing a prolonged keep away with a glacially slow Robert Baratheon? The game was so easy that I didn't even have to use Aegon's dragon to conquer Westeros. How lame is that?